Good morning. We are dealing with brick and we stopped yesterday with first class brick. Bricks are classified according to their compressive strength values. Minimum compressive strength required for a brick, minimum compressive strength is 3.5 Newton per mm square. 3.5 Newton per mm square. As per system international unit, around 35 kg per centimeter square. Very often, the country bricks, if it is not made properly, not adhering to the quality processing, and proper burning is not taking place, in actual practice, bricks fail to meet the standard, even bricks having lesser value than 3.5 Newton per mm square. But most constructions are taking place even with those bricks. But in due course, those buildings, there is a chance of showing cracks because of the excessive compressive strength developed and the bricks being of inferior quality will be subjected to cracks. So before construction, a few samples of bricks have to be assessed for their performance in service and whether they are conforming to the standard provisions of course according to the country's legislation. In India, the relevant code or standards, Bureau of Indian Standards, IS codes, BIS 1077, and 4395. These are the relevant numbers, 1077 and 4395. They are available in the net. Now all Bureau of Indian Standard codes are available in the web. Usually the stone brick, there are masonry units. They are called the masonry units. Masonry units are versatile in compression, but not that much in tension. That is a general case. Any material used for masonry work. Masonry work is building a wall is a masonry work. Building a foundation is a masonry work. Building a parapet is a masonry work. Building a compound wall is a masonry work. The persons who are engaged in laying the brick in different fashion are known as masons. And masons will be helped by the men helpers and women helpers. A crew will be there. There will be a head mason. Under him there will be a team of people. Just like all other organization, in construction also, there are different departments. One department is masonry department. So brick is a compressive resistant material. It can take compression, but it cannot take tension. The minimum compressive strength required is 3.5 Newton per mm square. The physical properties of bricks. There is an usage of color definition as brick red. You would have heard about that term, brick red. So that color has got a benchmark as brick red. So brick, a well-burned brick should be brown red in color, which is the brick red. And when you tap on the surface of the brick, hold the brick in one hand, tap with the other hand,
struck each other, the good quality bricks should produce clear metallic sound. If the sound is dull, the bricks should be rejected. Hardness test, make a scratch on the brick with your nail. The good quality bricks should not have any impression on the surface. If any marks are left over the surface,
you should hear a metallic ringing sound. Even though that is clay, which is well burned, has to produce a metallic ringing sound. That is the best brick, a first class brick. Will produce a metallic sound. The next, hold the brick vertically. Hold the brick vertically around 1 meter from the floor, almost a reasonably tough floor, not a soft floor, at the same time not very tough floor, reasonably tough floor. You can keep the brick as you are seeing on the edge horizontally also. You can keep the brick horizontally also. The worst condition is keeping it vertical. Suppose it succeeds in, if you keep like this, and if it succeeds, it's good. Or you can keep the brick horizontally at the center, you hold it, drop it from 1 meter high. If the brick doesn't break, it's a good. Metallic ring sound shall not fail. It is dropped from, free dropping from 1 meter high. Then water absorption is a mechanical property. Water absorption is a mechanical property. Before that, the brick surface of the brick shall not show map crackings. There should not be several cracks on the surface, any surface of the brick. That will considerably affect during the load transfer process. No? There should not be superficial cracks. Then the mechanical property, water absorption. Water absorption, if the brick is having more pores, or if the brick is not very burnt, possibility of absorbing more water will be there. So what you have to do is know the dry weight in air of the brick after keeping it dry in an oven for 24 hours. Take the dry weight, put the brick in water, submerge it for 24 hours, take it out after 24 hours, make the surface totally dry, make the surface dry, again take the weight, you take the weight. The difference, obviously, there will be increase in weight. The difference in weight, by the dry weight into 100 is the water absorption expressed in percentage. You can dry the brick before the load, before putting it in the water, or you take the brick, make it surface dry, put it in 24 hours, make it dry. Both. Anyway, you have to take the weight before putting it in the drying oven. So, difference in fully wet brick for 24 hours and fully dry brick divided by dry brick into 100. The standard says that it shall not exceed 20%. Even though it says 20%, better 15%. For brick to be good for construction, water absorption can be limited to 15%. Good bricks satisfy that condition. You can see when you are putting the bricks in water, lot of pebbles will come out. That is nothing but the air coming out of the pores of the brick. And those pores are filled by water. Bubbles, you can see. Lot of bubbles coming in the initial stages. Then they will go on reducing when those pores are filled with. Porous bricks are not good for construction. The quality of burning, the quality of preparation of the brick, brick earth are good. The brick will have only less. then the compressive strength, the engineering property, compressive strength of brick. As we have seen in the stone, you will have a compression testing machine. There are various compression testing machines. You have even a portable compression testing machine which you can go to take to the site of the brick making and do the test. Portable compression testing machine. So there you can get the strength. Usually to have an even surface, you will be just covering the surfaces with a binder, cement mortar. We have not been introduced that term cement mortar, that is why I am just telling that a padding will be given, cement mortar on both the surfaces, and brick will be laid on its face, then compression load will be applied, and the failure load divided by the resisting area will give you the compressive strength. That shall not be less than 3.5 Nm². That's a compressive strength. And another chemical property is the efflorescence. Especially when bricks are going to be laid near the bathrooms, urinals, where the area is acidic environment, and it is not plastered. Plastering is a process of covering the brickwork with cement mortar again. So the bricks are not resistive against efflorescence. You can see patches, white patches, especially near the ground where the dampness is more. Scaling on the surface of the brick. The scaling on the surface of the brick is called efflorescence. So what you do is you take a tray in which you keep water. You keep the bricks vertical, and wait for 24 hours and see whether during capillarity how far this water has gone up and is there any white color patches along the sides of the brick or on the surface of the brick. If it is not there, the good is resistive against efflorescence, and there is no free line which is coming out, leaching out of the brick. So efflorescence has to be checked. These are the usual tests done for the satisfactory confirmation of the quality of brick. This is a quality of brick. When the bricks are satisfactorily completing these specifications, those bricks can be employed for constructions. And they can be called as first class brick and burnt brick. So this is a short briefing of brick. You have nowadays, because of the ecological problem and non-availability of sand, because of legislative constraints and restrictions in land excavations, digging out, there are restrictions. So brick and tile factories, tile roofing tiles, clay products, there are ceramic materials. So many tile and brick factories are closing down because of the non-availability of raw materials. The brick earth cannot be taken. Sand restrictions are there. And it has got climatic implications. There will be an environmental effect of large scale burning of bricks. So bricks are gradually giving way to concrete bonds. or cement mortar blocks. To appreciate these blocks, we should know what concrete and cement mortar are. Anyway, for the time being, to wind up the masonry unit, we should tell something on cement mortar and cement concrete, cement mortar blocks and cement concrete blocks, solid blocks and hollow blocks in concrete. In cement mortar, hollow blocks are not available, but in cement concrete, you have both solid blocks and hollow blocks. By God's grace, we will see. Thank you. God bless.